Hey, what is up, everybody? I'm AvalancheFan133, and welcome back to my NHL 16 Be A Pro Goalie Mode. Today I'm playing in game number 14 of my 5th season in this Be A Pro mode at home against the New York Islanders. So far we are 10-3 to start the season. Very, very good. I can't remember. We started the season undefeated there for a while. We'll go over what games have gone by and so on. So after the win on opening night against Winnipeg, we won 4-2 against Ottawa, again with me in net. So I had a very good start to the season. I got benched here against Vancouver where we won 4-2, so three straight games. Four straight against Colorado, won 4-1, I started in that game. Five straight against Columbus, overtime win, I started that game too. I could have played a little better, but gave up a few okay goals and so on, and we ended up winning, so that's all that mattered. And then we lost our first game. I did not start this game. My goalie did come in relief at one point, which stunk, and they gave up two goals, I calculated. So we lost 6-3 against Colorado in our first loss, and then we lost against Dallas 4-2. I did start this game. Dallas really, really kind of outplayed us a little bit. I guess not too much. They had like 30 shots. I just gave up too many goals. I believe I turned the puck over behind the net for a goal in this game. Overall, not great. I got benched here where we won 4-3 against Buffalo. Then I didn't start against LA where we won 6-3. Then this was my last start. I had a 5-4 loss to Buffalo. Again, not quite on top of my game. So I ended up giving up too many goals. So I got to bounce back after that. We won 7-4 against Florida, 5-0 against Minnesota, 5-3 against Boston. And here I am starting against Islanders. I'm in the middle of a goaltender battle right now. The coach did say he was going to start me a little less for some reason when I still had pretty dang good numbers. So 7 games played, 4 wins, 138 saves, 88.5 save percentage. It was up above 90% there for a little while, but it's gone down, which is disappointing. But still 2.768 goals against average. Goals against average still pretty good. I can't remember if we have any injuries. It looks good there. We're good on the offense. We do have Ryan Ellis out. That's right. So this is our defensive core. Still not bad. It sucks that we have a pretty good defender out. But here's the guy I'm battling. Isn't doing too great, Adrian Rollings. He's got a better save percentage, but I got the better goals against average. He has a shutout, and he has 6 wins out of his 7 games played. I have only 4. So it is back and forth between me and this guy. I don't think there's anything else to check. I'll pull up standings like after this game. We are leading in the division, I think by 4 points above Chicago. Oh, good gosh, the Islanders have 94 offense. But we are scoring at a torrid pace. We are scoring like 4.3 goals per game on average, which is amazing. Islanders goaltending isn't too great. I wonder if they still have Halak. Still same gameplay settings. I don't think I have to mention that every time I start a game. I will just mention it if I ever change anything. I've been considering bumping down the injury occurrence, but it feels more realistic with the more injuries. Ray Ferraro is coming up in just a moment. But they're really hurting the teams I'm playing for a lot. But right now I'm leaving them. A good role translates how? You continue to not sure if I ever will change them. Alright, let's not watch this. I really only watch the intros like in playoff games or something. So here we go. I need a good bounce back game. I've had 2 bad games in a row. Our defense has been spectacular. And that's really good. Block there, Forsberg. James Neal and Peter Forsberg. Yes, we have Peter Forsberg. Now, Philip Forsberg and James Neal are like battling it out on the team in goals. Ooh, pass in front just missed. Last I saw, I think they both were at 8 goals. But Forsberg had some 7 assists or so, and Neal only had like 3. Ooh, pass in front for Forsberg, just couldn't handle it. And their goalie will cover. So this I'm recording on Monday, which is when my last episode came out. So I'm getting out ahead a little bit just because it's a new season and I've been playing a ton. Been excited. Shot on stopped. So I'm thinking of recording the start of my goaltender GM series again. After this, and I don't know whether that will come out Tuesday or Thursday, so I'm not sure. And we score on the board first. We've been scoring the first goal quite a lot this year, so it's been great. Now, if you remember, I don't remember when I made the change. I bumped down the goalie reaction speed, the CPU goalie reaction speed, another notch. His technique is good. I don't know if that's fully helping a ton, but my team is scoring a lot. I'm keeping an eye on that right now. Right now I'm riding my hot team, and if we keep up this ridiculous pace, I'm going to have to bump that up again because we are scoring a little too many, but I'm going to count that to a hot streak right now. Good block. My team has been blocking shots, taking away passes. Overall, I've had some really easy games. The last two games I've lost have been a little tougher, but mostly because we've had a defender injured, and that is the case tonight, so I've got to be sharp and alert and make sure I'm paying attention. Overall, I had a really good start to the season. I was focusing well. I was positioning myself well. I made some big saves. Despite my team plays great defense, every now and then there'll be a great chance from the other team. Behind the net. Out in front. Oh, snagged that one. I feel safe hanging on to that. I had no time to react to that, but my goalie gloved it. Nice job there. Probably could have seen that replay, but oh well. 12:35 left. We still got the lead. New York wins the faceoff. DeHaan shoots it wide. Islanders with the puck. Got to watch that guy out in front. Yep, there's that shot. I'm going to throw that to my right. Seth Jones will throw that up the boards. Hodgson gets crushed. Glad shot. Made the save there. Seth Jones missed, I think, one game. Let's see, who else? Yossi missed a game or two. And now Ryan Ellis is injured. So almost all of our defense has missed a game or so here early in the season. Our forwards have been pretty healthy. James Neal got injured in a game but came back to play the next game. So, I don't remember anybody missing any extended time. Oh boy, John Tavares. Making moves in the slot. Ooh, just kept that out with the pad. I was right on the line. Whoo, close chance there. James Neal working in, getting collapsed on by the entire Islanders team. Turned over, Pavelski. Pavelski has really played well for an 83 overall centerman. Centering this top line, he's done a great job. He hasn't been in the middle of everything. It has mostly been James Neal and Philip Forsberg. And then our defense helping out a lot. But wow. Pavelski's done pretty good. Ooh, just banging away at it on the side of the net. And they'll cover. It's not Halak in net. Looked like his name was Soderstrom or something like that. Slid back across from one point to the other. Pass down low to the slot, just missed. Through the neutral zone. New York will move up again. Shot up high. Got the glove save. I'm having trouble getting opportunities to pass the puck. So far, this game's been pretty good. So I've been missing my team play so far this season. Ooh, loose in front. Lupul tried to get that through, but their goalie doing pretty good. And so far, the second period has been hurting me. The Dallas game, I believe we had a 2-0 lead entering the second, and I gave up 2 goals in the second. And, oh, that'll be a penalty. I gave up 2 goals in the second, so we entered the third tied at 2, and then Dallas won the third. Our power play, I think, has been pretty average, nothing special. Our penalty kill started off the season killing 11 straight. Then we finally gave up one, so our penalty kill has been pretty good. Forsberg trying to get that puck on the side of the net, couldn't get it, slapped to center ice, and Jones had a good keep in, and he will send that one in with a ripper. 2-0 with the Seth Jones power play goal. That was just beautiful. I believe that's his first of the year. He had some 7 or so assists. So he's really helping out with the assists. But it's good to see him get on the board with a goal. Just over 3 minutes to go here in the first. Pavelski gets the only assist. And again, we're out to the 2-0 lead in the first period. Although I think the Buffalo game, I might have given up the first goal. My team actually almost came back in that game. It was a 5-4 loss, but really it wasn't that close like halfway through that game. It was like 5-2 or something. Buffalo. Comes Ladd in on the left side, dumps it in. Ooh, that almost deflected off that guy. Got the blocker save. That pass just missed. We'll slide all the way back down. Let's see. I don't know if there's anything else that's going on. I wanted to talk about what's been going on in the NHL. I keep thinking of that, and then I forget it right when I get into a game. The Avs have won 5 straight, and they're facing the Leafs tonight. By the time this is out, we'll know the results of that game, whether the Avs will be on a 6-game streak or whether the Leafs will end that. Semyon Varlamov has been amazing. He was just named the first star of, was it the week or month? No, it can't be month. I think the week. So we had 14 shots to their 6. I stopped all 6 against me. Wow, 14 shots. Great job, guys. They only had 69% passing percentage. So a great first period all around. Also, the Avs, I forgot to mention that win against the Blackhawks with that Patrick Kane scoring streak going, and Varlamov shut out the Blackhawks to end that scoring streak. That was just awesome. Find the net in front. Don't know where it is. I found it. And I'll hang on. What else has been going on? The Central Division, tight as ever. Clean win on the draw. I'm not completely, like, I don't follow a ton of the different teams and each conference too much in hockey. New York's in control. Most of my following just is the Avs. But I hear about stuff. Shot from the point gets deflected to the corner. So, I'd love to know what your guys' favorite teams are. And how are they doing? Like, how do you feel about them this year? Forsberg puts that one in for a 3-0 lead. This is just beautiful. This is how the season's been going for me. This is why I feel so good about the season. Despite I've had a little bit of a rocky last 2 starts, my team's scoring goals, so I don't ever feel like I'm out of the game. And we're playing such good defense. Nashville's built a 3-0 lead in this game, and they've had the puck almost the entire time. So 3-0 here early in the second. Predators prevail on the now I just want us to play good defense and I can just play it safe. Keep pushing the envelope though too. I don't know. If we keep playing in their zone, that'd be great. I just want to have a good game and win. So far, it looks pretty good for a win. Islanders setting up on this power play. Ooh, good active stick by Siemens. And he'll clear it. More time off the clock. Former Avs prospect. Not turning out too great in this Be a Pro. Oh, where is it? Okay. This is a first round pick. We got him because of the trade with the Blues. The Shattenkirk, Chris Stewart. Okay, no move. Okay. Whew. I slid way over and couldn't get back. Yeah, there's a goal. Santarelli's up there? Dang. Come on, guys. We need this face off in the clear. Yes. Pavelski will deflect it off the Islander defender and send it down and then steal it. Pavelski, shot stopped. Tried to go five hole. The Predators are back even. Santarelli back to Wilson. But overall, I feel like we've just been playing so well because I'm actually on a good team and we score. Is that a shorty or did the penalty end? I think the penalty might have ended. 4-0, Colin Wilson. But we had a really good game against the Blue Jackets. It was really competitive. Even the Stars was really competitive, and we lost that game. Buffalo was a good game, although I should have played better in that game. So overall, I don't think it's going to be like this every game. We're going to have competitive games. Right now, I'm riding this. I kind of deserve this easy of just games. Nothing I'm going to potentially change in the gameplay settings is going to affect the defense, though. So that's going to stay the same. The only thing I'm considering changing, the only two things, is the injury occurrence, which shouldn't change the gameplay, and the CPU goalie reaction speed. Because we are scoring a bit much, but I'm going to just ride it out a little longer. Perfect passing right through center. Islanders in again. Ooh, we're just collapsing on them and they're not getting any shots. Shea Weber working in, getting pinned against the board. Lupel helps him out and sends it behind the net. Fight for it. Aberg gets it in front. Oh, across. Great save. Their defense hasn't helped them out very much. Nashville's not done yet. They continue to build. So overall, I think that who's going to get it? He got it. Okay. Didn't know where that was for a second. My goalie hasn't been catching very many. But the overall of the defense on these teams really does affect how well they play. I'm really seeing that because Columbus didn't have a terrible defense. But they allowed more opportunities than this. Seth Jones with a shot breaks his stick. And also, I think we just have a better... We don't really have a better overall group of forwards, but they're performing better. Oh, I thought that was going to float in for a second. Back and forth. They finally lose it. James Neal skating back into our own end. Checked off the puck. Ooh, hug the post just in time. This is great pressure for the Islanders. Good check. Bad. Okay, come on, guys. Yossi gets it. Finally up to Neal. Come on. Don't play around with it. Hand over to Forsberg. Got some tired guys out there. Forsberg gets crushed. Neal shot stopped. And almost thrown in on their own goalie. Oh, boy. That would have been embarrassing. Not like that happened to me ever.
Puck collected by John Tavares.
Good. Now it's directed freaking to defense there against Tavares. I think that might have been Greiba. I don't know. Sent in. Forsberg after it. Man, he's been out there for a long time, hasn't he? Fight for it behind the net. We're unable to come up with it, but we blocked the pass. Good job by Forsberg. In front. Oh, great save. Their defense just not doing anything. 3 minutes left here in the second period. Overall, we've controlled this game completely. I wanted to really play, I wanted to record the Minnesota Wild game that we played, but I didn't start that game for one thing. Another thing, I was really playing a lot of games in a row and enjoying myself. Looks ahead to start something. We're getting a little sloppy in our own zone, but not too bad. Aberg in front just gets blocked on that one-timer. Loophole gets it after Aberg gets crushed. Pass in front, shot wide. Might have probably got deflected. Okposo moving down the wing. One more chance. Don't know if that hit something. I thought there was less time on the clock. That's why I moved so far over. But the second period's over. I hate that that says don't embarrass them. And then the comments below that don't really go along with don't embarrass them. It should be more like don't take this one for granted. Because we're up in this one, but we don't want to get overconfident. They could just come back with some quick goals and get right back into it. But oh well. That's just me nitpicking. The time on attack is very close. It doesn't feel like it's been like that in this game. Islanders' passing percentage has been terrible in this game. We're 1-for-1 on the power play. They're 0-for-1, and they only have 12 shots to our 21. Very good game. Hopefully my team keeps up the same play here in the third. 4-0. Just won a good defensive effort the rest of the game. And so far, that's the way it's been. Forsberg dumps it in as he takes another huge hit. I don't like him taking those hits. He's our guy. Islanders dump it in. Yossi to it first, kicks it out. Neil helps it out. Jones's pass, he gets it back, but it's turned over in neutral ice, and then we get it back. Pavelski gets crushed by Tavares. Poke check to the corner. He's got it. Shot, glove save. I'm hanging on to this one. Gotta remember, gotta just loosen up, gotta just play. Puck goes behind the net. Kick out in front. Santarelli to that first. Wilson has a lot of room on the wing, but decides to pass that to the Islanders. Ooh, pass gets tipped, but Ladd came back for it. Nielsen, Okposo. Shot was going wide, gloved it. If Ekholm had been further away, I might have passed it, but oh well. I don't like all these face-offs in our zone. The Predators, well, we win it. We haven't been a great face-off team. But we've been pretty good. Also find it somewhat ironic that Nashville was the team I faced in my goaltender GM, and yet now I'm playing with them in my Be a Pro. At least I've been forgetting to say some things in my episodes. I think I've covered everything. Strome gets crushed. The Islanders have it again, and we are just playing just super aggressive defense, and I love it. It's just, they make it so easy some games. We still don't have Ryan Ellis, although I guess he is an offensive D-man. Strome in. Got down and in front of him. Took away that angle. Ah, oh, I did not expect that pass across. dang it, that breaks up the shutout. I also on purposely didn't even mention the shutout because, yeah, this is in the back of my mind. I did the one thing I can't do is expect the shot.
I think that's one he should probably stop.
I should have had that. I could have easily had that, but I got mesmerized by the puck, and I expected the shot. And yet, I think he was on the backhand. So it's like I didn't need to go and attack him. He wasn't in a good shooting position. There was no point for me to go down and go after him. That was just a bad mistake. Those are the mistakes I need to clean up for me to be that elite goalie. Nielsen, shot stopped. He gets it back. Shot blocked. Sent all the way across. I slid a bit too far, but it's okay. Pass gets blocked by Pavelski, and he'll move it up. Okay, now that my shutout bid's over, I can relax a little bit, and we can just try to finish out this game.
Moves up the side with it now.
I hate it. I think that's part of the thing. Mentally, I'm defeating myself, and that's partially why I haven't had a shutout. I panic. I get scared. Oh, it's so good that pass went into his skates. It was too dangerous with him on the goal line. He could have just snuck that in. I had to play the shot there a little bit. But I mentally kind of screw myself on the shutout bids because I put extra pressure on myself. We got a guy going to the net. I got to watch him. Oh, the goalie covers, man. But he got it. So I really got to get by that. Man, Islanders out shooting a 7-0 here in the third. Come on, guys. They still had really good defense. Their shots haven't come from that great of opportunities. And we will get a power play. Ekholm. Oh, good pass up. I thought he was going to lose that. And now we lose it. So the team play's still not up there. I need at least a couple more passes. And this is the best opportunity I'm going to have on the power play. So I'm almost cheering for the Islanders to get it and clear it. We scored very fast on our first one with the Seth Jones slapper. I can't get that one. I guess I could have. They probably would have backed off. Oh, well. Hopefully I get another opportunity. My defender got back too fast. James Neal dumps it in. Pavelski after it. Oh, he got it. Got Neal in front, but didn't try to pass to him. Ekholm, slapper. Glove save. Only 38 seconds left on the power play. I need to just go for the puck if I got the opportunity. And we win another draw. Gosh, dang it. And that squeaks out the center. Kuhlman will dump it in.
Taken behind by Bailey. Slot shot.
Glove saves. That one I can pass.
The Islanders have killed it all.
I don't know if that's going to do it on the passing. And that goes out of play. Just over the boards. Into the bench. Overall, I'm going to bounce back in this game and get a win. So I'm happy about that. We got our four goals pretty fast, but slowed down since. This third period hasn't been great for us, but we might have relaxed a little bit because of the lead. Nash? I don't know if that's Rick Nash. I think it is, actually. I remember seeing him on the Islanders. Like last year when I was looking at the rosters. Ooh, Santarelli, I think. Yep, he just bumped off that puck. Shot deflects wide. Santarelli with it again. Shot stopped. Another chance. Ooh, shot stopped as he gets that over to Wilson. We're under a minute here. Rick Nash. Great goal scorer through the years. Just too many moves. Lost the puck. And Smith into the Islander end. Loses the puck. And Ladd will move up. Under 30 seconds to play. Looking for options. Pass below the goal line. Had to make sure he wasn't going to drive the net there. DeHaan, shot. Ooh, I got a good passing opportunity there as they backed off. I'm a little quick saying shot. I'm just seeing the pass across and I panic. And we'll get another. Just a little salt in the wound. 4.9 seconds left as we make it 5-1. Santarelli. I believe that pulls him ahead of Neil and Forsberg now in the team with goals. That was just a beautiful shot. So I get my 5th win, I think, of the year. Overall, it is just night and day between the Predators and Blue Jackets. It also felt really good beating the Blue Jackets, even though it was closer than I wanted it to be. I would love to have that been a shutout, blowout of a game. And I also almost decided to record that, but it was so early in the season, and I was on a roll with playing games, I decided to wait. We do face the Blue Jackets again, I believe in March. So, if I start that game, maybe that'll be a recorded game. And dang it, if I just hadn't made that one small mistake, I would have had a shutout. But I believe I'm going to get one this year with how good our defense is and how I've already been close like 2 or 3 times now. And I really feel like it's going to be possible this year. And dang, still didn't get the team play. That would have been like 3 or 4 more passes to get that. Ugh, that sucks. I'm just not getting that many opportunities. I might just have to force a few passes with a guy sitting right out in front. But one goal off of 21 shots. It's still a great game. Great bounce back. I'm glad I finally won another game. And my team just blew up with goals. Santarelli, a 3-point night. Wilson had 2 goals. Seth Jones had his first goal of the year and 4 hits. Great game. Just great. We are going to be a great team this year, and I'm so excited. It's already 2 good recorded games I've had. I don't know how many games I'm going to get to play this season, though. Joffrey Leupel's going to be out. See, this is why I'm thinking about bumping down the injuries, because it's almost every game now. And that isn't quite realistic. 9 hours, I'm going to put 1 into glove, 1 into stick, and 1 into sprint. So I'm really working on glove and stick a lot more. Just so my goalie makes more saves. So my progress, even though I want to get that speed up another notch, I'm not starting against Calgary. Well, that's disappointing. James Neal will be off the roster for a while with an injury. Oh boy, I hope that doesn't affect our offense too much. And we lost our first overtime game. Or shootout. Not starting against Detroit either. Boy, I've had a good year and I don't know how the coach, like, determines who's going to start. It seems like it's a combination of the letter grades and your stats, but I'm not sure. Not starting against Tampa Bay. And Fiala's out with an injury now. Ryan Ellis is back. That's good. Hey, too many injuries. Okay, so this time I'm going to go with stick and glove and the core training. So that evened out well. And I'll get to start against Winnipeg. Same team I beat in the first game of the season. There's my progress again. Didn't start any games that week, unfortunately. That seems like I'm not going to start. Like, I'm going to start every 4th game or so. But we had some close games and we lost 2. Shootout loss, and shootout win. So, come on, coach. You gotta freaking give me some opportunities. It's too early in the season to say, oh yeah, we're not gonna start you. Look at this. Those are career high numbers so far. I mean, not the wins quite yet, but man, think the most wins I've had was like 7 or something. So that's pretty close. Let's look at the lines. Wilson got moved up to the first line, although he has 6 goals and 13 assists. He's been playing on the second line this year. It's been ridiculous. Joe Pavelski with a lot of assists. Philip Forsberg's been pretty good. Lupul is okay now and playing. He hasn't done great, but he's been on the third line, and he's been pretty good on that third line. Santarelli, 9 goals, 8. Ugh. It's just been great. Forsberg does have 10 goals now. Kirkland's our rookie. He only has a goal and 3 assists, so not great. Siemens is going to be on that fourth line, so gosh dang it. So who's playing defense now? Oh, Ellis is back. That's right. So we have our defensive core here, so I'm happy with that. Just our offense might struggle without James Neal. Just look at how his stats look. 91.4, 2.573. I still have a better goals against average, huh? He has a better save percentage and a lot more saves, despite only 2 more games. I'm not facing very many shots per game usually. It's partially because of our defense, but partially because the gameplay settings don't allow for it too much, and I can't adjust that. It's the one gripe I really have. Look at standings, and then I think that'll about do it. We're 2 points up on the Blackhawks, and they have a game in hand. Oh boy. We've been losing some lately. Wild also have 23 points. They're the former Stanley Cup champions. They won the Stanley Cup last year. We've dipped below 4 goals per game. But that's okay. It's probably going to even out a little more. Our goals against is higher than I wanted, but still not bad. Better than it was with Columbus. And I think that about does it. I have 1 more game in my evaluation period. If I can just have a really good game on team play, then I'll have all greens, and maybe the coach will turn it around for me and give me some extra starts. Overall, starting off this season well, got a good numbers. Nashville's a great defensive team. I'm really glad I picked them. 86 overall still, that helps me out a bunch too on my goalie. Next episode, dang, we're already most way through November. I kept wanting to say December. So next episode might come early to mid-December, I'd expect. Chicago would be a great game, but that's a little late. I would love it to be a division game. Let me know, guys, if there's any game you might prefer, although I might record the next episode before this episode's out. So we will see. I also don't know, as it's going every other day, I would have an episode on Christmas. I don't know if I'm going to put one out on Christmas or not yet. I'm leaning towards not, so probably don't expect one, although I might still do it. I don't know. It wouldn't be any trouble because I can get everything done like the night before. But anyways, let me know if there's any of these games you would prefer me play. Dallas or Colorado might be an okay game. St. Louis is a little too soon. Dallas might be too soon too. Ideally, I would love to play the Chicago game, but also I don't know if I'll start. Anyways, guys, I think that does it. If you liked the video, please leave a like. That helps me out a bunch. And if you have any comments, questions, anything you would like to know or tell me, leave them in the comments below. And also, I feel like mentioning, if you want to check out any of my other content, I leave links in the description. There'll also be annotations after I'm done blabbing here, and some links in that. And I think that does it. I'm AvalancheFan133, and I will talk to you guys later. Overall wise, he's the best up there, and I think deservingly he's the best up there. He can do everything. He's won the cup multiple times. Is it twice or more? I don't even remember anymore. I'm taking Jonathan Toews, even though I'm not...
I'm pretty much a Blackhawk hater at this point. Back to the point. Ooh, one-timer by Chara. Somehow stopped by Fleury. Oh, McKinnon with a chance. But just gets stopped, and he steals it. Crew down low. Across. What a save! Wow!